Since the Honorable Chief Justice of India happens to be the visitor of this university, so I thought it proper to share with you that the correct pronunciation of his name is Chief Justice Deepak Misra and not Chief Justice Deepak Misra. I have shared this viewpoint only to tell you because he happens to be well connected with your university. Friends, I am glad to be here for the third Foundation Day lecture of the National Law University, Odisha. My greetings to all of you on this auspicious Foundation Day. This is one of 19 national law schools in our country, the first such institution having been founded in 1986 as the National Law School of India, Bangalore. Over the past three decades, this cohort of law universities has revolutionized legal education in India. The National Law University of Odisha is one of the younger and more dynamic members of this group. Set up a decade ago, in 2008, it builds on the legacy of several legal luminaries of this state, beginning with the pioneering advocate and nation builder Madhusudan Das, and extending to the current Chief Justice of India, Justice Deepak Misra. This institution has become a major center for legal education in not just Odisha, but across our country. It is recognized as a center of excellence, attracting students from, I have been told, 25 of India's 29 states. It can be said that today I have the privilege of addressing rather many India. The modernization of the legal profession has kept pace with the rise in opportunities for law graduates and young lawyers. While litigation in the courtroom remains at the core of legal practice, a law graduate today finds many avenues open to him or her that were simply not available to previous generations. As our economy has grown, the legal profession too has expanded. Commercial and business law have become more important, complex, and intellectually stimulating. If this is true domestically, it is also true internationally. Trade and commerce, international agreements, and even the craft of diplomacy increasingly turn to lawyers and legal minds for negotiations and skilled drafting of texts. Arbitration and the globalization of legal services through mechanisms such as outsourcing have also linked today's lawyers with the rest of our planet. It is on legal professionals that we depend to not merely make sense of the world as it is, but also the world as it is becoming. This is especially true for technology now, often with technology outpacing changes in the law. As a result, lawyers are called upon to develop regulatory frameworks for and in extremely dynamic and evolving technological environments. This has been true to cyberspace and for internet law. In the years ahead, legal teaching institutions as well as practitioners will have to meet many more such challenges. They will have to create rules and legal frameworks for outer space, for the fourth industrial revolution, and for artificial intelligence. They will have to write laws for new equations between humans and machines, whether driverless cars or innovations in agriculture and medicines. For the legal students of today, such as the bright boys and girls of this institution, this opens up almost limitless opportunities. Your training and skills can leave an impact on a wider variety of human endeavors and sectors than was possible in the case of your predecessors. It is for legal education institutions to enhance this multidisciplinary as well as interdisciplinary approach of law and of the legal profession. Here, I am happy to note that the National Law University Odisha is at the frontier of legal education and is equipping its students in new fields and introducing them to new possibilities. Using the Government of India's Global Initiative for Academic Networks or GYAN program, this university has offered over the past year courses in international e-commerce law and in corporate governance in India. These have involved guest faculty from the United States and Singapore also. I am also glad to note the curriculum of the university is socially relevant, with a focus on development of an entrepreneurial and innovative mindset. The clinical course on legal aid and PIL, as well as law and entrepreneurship course, stands testimony to this. Set up in 2015, the Distance Education Center of National Law University Odisha is, I understand, developing distance education and massive open online courses under SWAYAM. This is an initiative of the Government of India to provide opportunities for lifelong learning. I have been told that from July this year, a distance education and online course on child rights, developed with the support of UNICEF, will be introduced. I commend this effort. For all its advances, at its roots, the legal profession has a simple aspiration for the lawyer to be a voice for the voiceless and to bring justice to the most deprived, to secure the universal and inalienable rights of every child is an inspiration that makes the legal profession just so meaningful. Ladies and gentlemen, over the years, our understanding of law and its applications has become larger as well as more sophisticated. The nuances of privacy and of individual choice, the deeper integration of the concept of rights and responsibilities, and the search for the happy mean between space and autonomy for innovation and regulation for the greater common good in fields such as biotechnology and communication technology are all examples. Yet, in all this, are we paying enough attention to issues of legal infrastructure and access to justice, especially for ordinary citizens? I have spoken earlier of the need to enhance legal literacy and simplify legal rules, as well as for the quick availability of certified translated copies of high court judgments in the local language of the state or region. All these will take justice closer to the people. I am happy to learn that some high courts have responded to this positively. But while the judicial system has its responsibilities, so does the lawyer community. A community to which such students of this institution will soon belong. An advocate is a law officer of the court. He or she has a responsibility to the client, but also a duty to assist the court in delivery of justice. Our legal system has a reputation for being expensive and for being prone to delays. The use and abuse of the instrument of adjournments is often done by advocates who see adjournment as a tactic to slow down proceedings rather than a response to a genuine emergency. This adds to the cost of obtaining justice for litigant. It would be travesty of our Republican ethic if a poor person did not get the same access to the law as a rich person. Unfortunately, in practice, this is happening. These are issues for the emerging generation of lawyers, including those studying at this institution, to ponder and to rectify in the course of their careers. The opportunities and rewards of this profession, both intellectual and financial, are enormous. And this is welcome. But a good legal professional is not just somebody with a mind. He or she is also somebody with a heart. Dear students, on this auspicious occasion of Founding Day, I would rather appeal to all of you to take a pledge. Whenever you start your legal career, please do whatever you can with a sense to pay back to the society. May the National Law University Odisha save fine minds and may it nurture warm hearts. Thank you. Jai Hind.